This episode of Musical Hell is brought to you by Midnight Musicals. Welcome to the podcast Musical Underground. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Diva from Musical Hell, and I know the score.
As we approach the year mark of being in pandemic mode, now is a good time to talk about how we've approached theater in a virtual space. While there have been several examples of musicals filmed in a traditional fashion and released via web streaming, 2020 saw performers contributing remotely, each providing a part of the whole from whatever quarantined space they were in. This led to Zoom performances, online readings, shameless plug incoming, and perhaps the most emblematic creative effort of the year, Ratatouille the TikTok Musical, a unique collaboration born from a bunch of creative types with a lot of spare time. Yet, strangely, this is not the first collaborative musical the internet has engendered. Let's look at an earlier prototype of this kind of virtual production, 2017's Undertale the Musical. Based on the popular RPG by Toby Fox and using his soundtrack as a base, Undertale the Musical was produced on the YouTube channel Man on the Internet and features the work of multiple voice actors, fan artists, and lyricists who retell the story of a child who falls into a world of monsters and must ultimately decide the fate of two worlds. The visual part of the production is made up of video game footage, still drawings, and some limited animation. The results have proven rather popular, with over 3 million views on YouTube. So, how do they play out, and what can they tell us of the advantages and pitfalls of online collaboration? One of the great things about being able to connect with people all over the world is that it puts you in touch with some amazingly talented folks. So it is here. The vocalists for this video are all excellent and well-matched to the characters. I especially liked the performers for Toriel and Asgore. Lindsay Bolin has a sweet, clear voice that radiates motherly care, even when she's trying to take you down.
I don't want you to leave this happy home. It's not safe for a child out there alone.
And Daniel Wagner's deep tones resonate with both grief and ominousness.
Oh, dear child, I'm sorry. Now you face the Mountain King.
However, when you put something together essentially by committee, the results can be a bit hit or miss. This is the case with the lyrics, especially since they're built on Fox's already existing soundtrack. I can see why they did it. It's an excellent score with lots of distinct character and mood themes, which on paper makes it a really good choice for a musical drama. But you can tell the melodies weren't written with lyrics in mind. Some work rather well, like Flowey's sing-song leitmotif. It's simple and easy to sing along with, and the character invites a lot of creepy dissonances and ironically dark lyrics.
I will not bow down, I will not suffer, I will not ever cry. This is the end of your very short path to Dulu Kiddo. Die!
Damn, and I thought Audrey 2 was a creepy plant. Okay. On the other hand, Papyrus's theme has a lot of interval jumps and a somewhat irregular meter, which makes it very difficult to write words for without sounding clumsy. Although it does kind of fit the eager, overly ambitious character.
Ungod, now human, now you face Papyrus. Though the gods fail to stop you, I can do it alone. So be prepared for the ultimate tussle as you try to show your muscle in this battle of bones.
Length is also a bit of an issue. Undertale the Musical runs at just over 4 hours, which is quite a marathon for a fan-based project. The video could definitely benefit by cutting some of the filler, particularly the dating scenes.
That's all prepared. We will turn up the heat, turn the stove to the max, and let your passion shine. The dial only goes right. We can't turn all this off. This is what it is like when you cook with undying.
But on the the whole, Undertale the Musical is an early demonstration of a model that became one of the rare bright spots of 2020. People reaching past physical barriers of time and space to create something special. And that's something that can always give you a little boost of hope and determination. I'm Diva, I know the score, and now, so do you.
Golden Child.